Hey guys, so I've been uploading some videos. I did a live stream earlier this morning regarding these high winds we're having. It's super crazy. This is the highest winds I've ever seen out where I live. And keep in mind, we get a lot of wind, okay? So much wind, so that I actually got a problem, which kind of sucks. So it's so windy that let me try to see if I can explain this to you guys. So I'm in my house, I'm looking out the window here. So that one wind turbine up there, that's my workhorse right there. That bad boy, just come on, focus. I'm so sorry, it's having a hard time focus. Today's not a good day. Let's see. There it is. Okay, so the one way up there is my workhorse. That bad boy puts out a lot of power, okay? The pulley I have turned off, and this other windmill up here is turned off as well. We have so much wind that my battery bank was charged at like 4:30 this morning, completely charged. The wind's been keeping me up for hours because I'm outside making sure stuff don't blow away, but it's pretty crazy right now. So here's the issue. The monster up there has stopped working. Do you see the blades right now? They're barely turning up there. They're turning very slow. And the wind right now is insane. So I've been monitoring my off-grid system, and come to find out, that bad boy right there has been putting over 50 amps. On my amp meter, the amp meter is just pegged all the way out. It cannot go anymore. Pegged all the way the hell out. And I was watching, I was thinking, okay, it's not too bad. I was waiting for my fuse to blow or whatever. Then I walk in the house and I hear, wah! And I'm like, what the hell? So I run outside to go look at how much amps is coming out of it, and it's saying zero. Okay? It's saying zero, and it's turning slow. So when it's turning slow like that, that means it's shorted. That means if you short all the wires together, it's like stopping the wind turbine like right now. So I thought my bridge rectifier gave out on me. So I disconnected the wild three-phase AC that's going to the bridge rectifier, because I thought maybe the bridge rectifier internally gave out and was shorting my wind turbine out. So I took off the three-phase, and if you take the three-phase wires off the bridge rectifier, it's basically just going to free spin without any brakes, without anything. It's just going to free spin. And right now, I'll show you when I walk out there, I have disconnected the three-phase coming into the bridge rectifiers, and I'm still having a short. So that means my short is up at the top, which is bad news, because that means I have to take down my wind turbine and open it up and see what happened. Now keep in mind, this wind turbine's been working for over 3 years, no problems. The only thing I had to do was replace the tail. So over 3 years, producing day in and day out, day in and day out, day in and day out. It's a workhorse. It works good until today. It's been putting out a lot of good power today. That's why my batteries are pretty, they're supercharged right now, is because of that one wind turbine up there. But now since it's blown out, I think the coil, the stator up there, either a couple things has happened. Either the stator up there has shorted because it's went over its rated amperage, or where the three wires that go into the back of it for the three phase that come down the pole and go to the bridge rectifier, they may have touched or got vibrated loose for some reason, which I doubt, but it could be a possibility. And that's what's shorting it out right now from stopping it from spinning. Okay? So let me take you guys outside and show you guys. Let me grab my slippers. What I got going on. Battery voltage. Now keep in mind, my battery voltage was over 15 because I have everything in my house on because I got so much power right now. Solar panels are putting out 40 amps. Wind turbine, for the very first time, it's out. There's nothing coming out now. When normally this thing, I mean, when it broke, it was pegged past the 50. Past 50. This thing couldn't go any further. Past 50. So I came down to my bridge rectifiers here. I just took off all the wires because I'm doing some testing to figure out what the hell's going on here. So this bridge rectifier right here is actually the one that's been connected to my tall wind turbine, the one that's out right now, that should be working. So when it gave me this problem, I started looking at my bridge rectifier, and the bridge rectifier itself is delaminating, it's falling apart. So I may have pushed the bridge rectifier beyond its recommended amperage, and this one is rated for 50 amps. And I know I was pegged out past 50 amps. So this bridge rectifier, even if it does work or whatever, after I figure out what's really going on with the wind turbine, I'm not going to reuse this. I'm going to throw this bridge rectifier away and go, but I already have a 100 amp bridge rectifier I'm going to put in. But here's my point. So here is the three wires that come off of that tall wind turbine, the Wild three-phase AC, and it connects to your bridge rectifier. If you disconnect all of these from your bridge rectifier, your wind turbine should spin freely, because there's no load on it, so it should just spin completely free. And as you guys can see, I have it disconnected. I have everything disconnected. I mean, from my bridge rectifiers. This right here is just the negative cable, but I can leave the negative on. It doesn't matter. But so that means I gotta take apart the big tall wind turbine and figure out what's going on with it. Considering I've built these things and put them together myself, using other people and other brands parts and to make mine, I pretty much know what's happening. There's only a couple things in there, and that's the stator. So either the stator has fried out on me, I have pushed the limits on my system as far as the bridge rectifier and what my stator can handle, or maybe where the three-phase wires are connected to the stator, maybe something has come loose or is touching and is grounding it out and preventing it from spinning right now. So this is just an update of the live video stream that I did earlier this morning, talking about the wind turbines and stuff. And holy crap, guys, holy crap. I don't even know what else to say. I mean, this holy crap, the wind is freaking insane, guys. Insane. In the 3 years that I've been out here, I've never seen wind this strong. And keep in mind, we've had hurricanes past the islands and destroy all around the islands, and we have never come close to this. And of course, we don't have no hurricane warning, no nothing. In fact, on my phone, it popped up saying that we're supposed to have flash flooding, not high winds. So the people at the newsroom or wherever they're at putting out that information need to get it straight, because this is like hurricane winds out here. Like, holy crap. I'm just lucky everything else is not blowing around. So I'm trying to determine what's going on with this system now. But since it's too windy to even drop the real tall wind turbine, I'm just going to have to wait till the wind dies off completely before I can screw around with it. So what I am going to do, I mean, I am fully charged, so I'm not worried about power, because I've been fully charged for since fucking 3 o'clock this morning. Excuse my language. But so if my voltage starts dropping down on me, I still have a backup. I still have that pulley wind turbine, and the pulley wind turbine I can wire to this bridge rectifier where it's still good. This bridge rectifier is shot now. I can wire it up here, and then I can use the pulley wind turbine to give me juice to power myself. I mean, power my system here. But considering that I got a lot of good voltage and stuff, I can be good all day, so it's not an issue. But I'm just concerned now. And here's that little probe that I put in there to check the temperature of this thing. And now, yeah, this thing is freaking pretty much had it. I mean, I don't know if you guys can see that. See where it's actually separated? It's actually coming out. And you can see where it's melted. All of this. And this is gooey when it's supposed to be hard. So, FYI guys, if you guys are putting up wind turbines like mine, I mean, keep in mind, those bridge rectifiers have lasted over 3 years. No problems until right now. And it's because of these winds, I've just put the system has been pushed over the limit as far as what it can handle. I mean, holy crap. Holy crap.
This is scary winds. We're used to winds, but this is scary winds, guys. Like, I'm scared my fucking solar panels are gonna blow off and my roof's gonna blow off. It's that insane. Let me take you guys back and show you guys the turbines on the hill again. That one should be spinning right now, but it's off. It should be spinning. So the wind has either done two things. I know the bridge rectifier is shot, but that still doesn't explain now because I disconnected everything, and that should be free spinning right now. So that means up in there I need to take it apart and figure it out, but I'm not doing that today. It's too unsafe to be outside with these winds. It's crazy. So worst case scenario, maybe later on this afternoon, if I need extra power, I can just go ahead and turn on the pulley run. The pulley's spinning right now, but it's off, so because I got so much power. And then this one turbine up that's up here right now is for low wind, so that's turned off. So yeah, first time in 3 years, guys. Today is Sunday. That one is finally conked out on me. And it's probably, I don't know, I gotta wait till I take it down and look at it, but I wanna say, because when the amp meter was past 50, I mean past 50, like just pegged out, I mean, it couldn't go anymore, you know what I mean? And then that's finally when it went out, and I've seen it gone 45 to 50 before, but never go past 50, I mean like, and stay past 50, just don't come down, just pegged way past 50, topped the hell out. So I may have the wind may have pushed my stator up there beyond its limits, because I'm assuming it was probably at like 60 amps or 65 amps. I mean, because the needle was just pegged and it wasn't even moving, it was just stuck. And then finally, when it gave out, it dropped back down because now it's not getting any current. So, holy crap, guys! It's a pretty exciting day, I tell you that. Oh man. But see, that's the reason why you have other wind turbines too and solar panels. So that way, if one thing does go down, you know, you're not super stressed. You can be like, okay, well, no big deal. We'll just wait till the wind dies down or another day. We can take it down because we're relying on this one. We're relying on this one plus the solar panels. So having multiple sources of charging, multiple charging sources is a must. Because just in case something happens like this with yours and you only had that one and not these other ones, oh, you'd be a sitting duck right now. I mean, your batteries would probably be completely charged, but here's the thing. Come tomorrow or the next day when your battery voltage starts to really drop and you need to charge it back up, if that's still broken, then you gotta figure out another way to charge your batteries. So, wow, I can't believe it. 3 years and I was actually home to see it freaking conk out on us. Wow. Wow. I have a video, a video clip that I'm going to post onto this video right after you guys are done watching this right here, right on this video on the end. And it's me at my father's house. And he's got wind turbines and solar and all that kind of stuff too. But his windmill kept popping his 40 amps and 50 amp fuses. He went to the store and bought bigger fuses. He had to get a 60 and an 80 amp fuse. So he's got a 60 amp in there right now, and his meter, I'll show you, it's in the video, his meter is pegged, pretty much pegged out. It's hitting between 45 and 50s, 45s and 50s. So these wind turbines work, that's for sure, but just fine tuning them and making them work the way you want them to work and that kind of stuff. You know, technically I could have just shut down the wind turbines because I had more than enough power. I could have just shut them down and would have been fine. But I wanted to see what the limits was. You always have to push yourself to the limit, push your things to the limits. And today we have done that. We have pushed this bad boy to the limit. Hey guys, so I've been uploading a bunch of live videos and videos of what's going on today. And we've getting some insane winds, guys. This is my father's and my mother's house. They live off the grid too. They have a windmill up there, and you guys can just hear that thing going. Do you guys hear that? So this is
This is his off-grid power shack. So guys, I wanted to show you guys something. So this system is my mother and father's setup. They're 12 volt as well. So he's got a bunch of batteries, as you guys can see. Right? But the issue he's having right now is the wind turbine is putting out so much amps and so much power, it keeps busting the fuses. And the fuses that we have in here are, I think, rated for 50 amps for his system. And they keep popping. So he actually ran to town to see if he could go buy some higher amperage, more than 50 amps to handle this, because it's putting out so much power, it's just popping the fuses. And that's his solar. Let's see if we can zoom in. That's his solar, and the wind turbine is amps are off right now because the fuse is blown. So he's replacing the fuse right now. He's buying another fuse to put on there. So right now that wind turbine is free spinning. It's not putting out any power right now because it keeps blowing the fuse. So like I said, he went and got some more bigger fuses, and then once he puts the fuse back on, it'll still do exactly what it's doing now and just put out power. So as you guys can see, the wind is crazy today. The windmill is like, holy crap. Hey guys, so this is the update on my wind turbine meltdown. Here's the 50 amp bridge rectifier. This is the very first bridge rectifier I ever bought 3 years ago. I mean, I've bought more since, but this is the very first one I've ever bought 3 years ago that was hooked up to my big wind turbine. And if you guys watched the beginning of this video, I explained to you guys what was the symptoms and what happened to my wind turbine. But I want to show you guys what the deal is with this bad boy is. First of all, if you guys can see, if you guys can see right here, that should be flush, like it is flush and inset, like it is on this side. Yeah. So when you look at this, this thing was getting super hot, right? And I usually keep a fan on it to keep it cool, just to kind of prolong the life on it. But since we've been having that crazy wind, and I mean really crazy, I mean my amp meter pegged out past 50, and then it made a weird noise and then it stopped working. So I'm inspecting the bridge rectifier, and I mean if you just look at this really closely, you can see how hot this has got. I mean this is 3 years old, so it's been used a lot, but you can see all the way around the edge here where it's separating from the cooling vents here, the heat sink. Okay, you can also see where all this is the positive and this is the negative. Oh no, I'm sorry, this is the positive right here and this is the negative. But if you look real close right here, you can see that it's all melted. It's all melted. You can even see this discoloration right there, where it's it looks like it's kind of brownish red right there and all up in here. And this one's got a puddle that's underneath it. It's all dried up now. When this thing gets hot, this thing actually gets like gooey. And it starts to melt. So this side is melted. It's got super red hot right here. You can see where it's at. This has gotten melted where it's actually had a puddle. Right? And you guys can look down in here. And you can see right here where my thumb's at, where it started to melt onto the terminal on both sides. And you can also see the same thing right here and a little bit right there. Right? And then if we turn it like this and we look at it at an angle, you can actually see where it's gotten so hot that it's actually separating right here. All around the edge. You can see where all the terminals are. They're all hot. They all got really hot. And you can see where this compound that they put in here to hold the circuit together, it just gets melted. So you can see how bad this thing has gone. I mean, this is the back of it. Nothing major, it's just a heat sink. And then in here, so this is your bridge rectifier. It takes the wild three-phase AC that's coming in from your wind turbine right here, and then converts it into usable DC right here where it comes out. So, the other one that I have out there that's on the pulley wind turbine is pretty new. I've had it for a while and never used it, and then I hooked it up for that wind turbine. So it's out there. I also, ever since I bought this, I did notice how it got, really gooey when it gets hot. So I actually bought, a 100 amp bridge rectifier, three phase, bridge rectifier. And the 100 amp doesn't even have this. It's a heavy duty unit. It's really well made. So if you guys are thinking about doing these wind turbines and stuff, like I said, this has worked for over 3 years, you know, until now where I got the issue where we had these really crazy winds. I mean, this is the windiest I've seen out here since I've lived out in this area and building my off-grid home. So, but FYI, you guys may want to look for the ones that don't have this type of filling here. Or if you look for a 100 amp model, it'll be all one whole solid unit. It won't even have none of this epoxy or whatever they use to cover up the circuit in there. So you can kind of see this is kind of a bad design to begin with, because if it gets this hot and it's doing this to this right here where it's melting everything, this heat sink should technically be a lot bigger, like way bigger. So, just FYI, guys. So, this part's failed on me. It just melted down. So, I'm going to throw this piece away. And I'm going to go hook up another one. And then, that takes care of this issue. But, the other issue I'm still dealing with now is my turbine. Because, even after I disconnected everything, and I showed you guys in the video that, you know, it should be free spinning, it's not. So, that means, up in the turbine, either two things have gone wrong. Either the stator coils went beyond its recommended limit as far as amps being put out, because like I said, the amp meter was pegged out, okay? So once it hit 50, I don't know how much farther it went past 50, because my amp meter only goes up to 50. So I don't know what the maximum was before it finally malfunctioned, okay? So it's either going to be the stator coil, that's in there that went beyond the limit and the current got too high on it and burnt out. Or it's where in the back of the windmill where there's three wires that connect to the actual stator itself. Maybe one of those wires because all the vibration and because I mean it was pretty crazy. And like I said, I haven't done no maintenance on that wind turbine in 3 years. All I did was replace the tail, fix the tail up. That's all I did. So it could, there's the second possibility could be where those connections are at, where maybe they got loose somehow and now they're touching. Because if they touch each other, then it's gonna like short it out, so it's gonna do the symptoms like we see right now. So either the stator coils are burnt out and shorted, and that's why it's doing what it's doing now, or the wires in the back that are connected to the three connections at the top of the windmill, and the wires run down to the bridge rectifier up there at the windmill. Something have maybe come loose or broke, and is touching each other and creating that short. So, but we've had a couple things fail today. We've had this fail on us today. And the windmill actually conked out. And you know, the surprising thing about all of this is my system is actually fused at 50 amps for the wind turbines. So once it hits 50 amps, it's supposed to pop that fuse. And my fuse is in still good shape. It didn't even come close to popping for some reason. So, but the other thing is that it may have only, you know, gone above the 50 for like, you know, a little bit of a time. And didn't give enough time for the fuse to actually heat up and then pop. So that could have been the issue as well. But I was hoping that the fuse would have blown, because if the fuse would have popped on us, or on me at least, that would have probably saved my wind turbine from blowing up or melting down up there. So be careful when you buy these things. Make sure you know, you're looking for some other ones. I mean, they work. These ones right here work. But they sell some better ones where it's a solid metal unit. It's very heavy duty. There's none of this epoxy stuff. So that's the ones I bought for the new house. And I actually bought one as a backup for this, my 12-volt off-grid system that I'm in now, just in case something like this did happen. So luckily, I'm smart enough where I usually buy two of everything. I buy two water pumps. I buy two of everything. And so that way, if this happens, I always have a backup where I can slap it on there and I'm back up and running. So this one's failed. So now I got to go take down the wind turbine in the next day or two, take it apart and see what's going on in there. And then when I do that, I'll take a little video and show you guys what burnt out or what melted or what blew up, or, you know, I'll just show you guys me taking it apart and investigating and seeing what's going on. So I got 3 years out of this bridge rectifier right here. And I really hope that my wind turbine on the top, I really hope it's just a matter of one of the connections came loose and they're touching each other, because that'd be the best case scenario. Because if it is, and all I gotta do is separate them or make sure I make the nuts nice and tight again, separate them, and then we're up and running. But if the stator coil, the copper coil up there, fried and it's gone, then that means I gotta replace that stator so that way I can get my wind turbine up. Because the only thing that's in there really is the casing that holds everything together. There's the rotor that's in the middle that's just got magnets. So there's no wire on that. It's just magnets. Then the outside, which is the stator, which is the copper coils. So there's only a couple things that could go wrong, you know. So it's either the connections on the back or the actual copper stator coil that malfunctioned on me. But right now I got the pulley wind turbine up and running. So, because I, you know, I had the video going where I had too much power coming out, so I had the other two off, and I only had the one big one that was hooked up to this one on. So now, since this one blew out on me, I got the pulley wind turbine on, and it's producing power and keeping my batteries charged and stuff. So it's nice to have a secondary backup. But yeah, I hope this video helped you guys out, and just look out for things. You know, you guys may want to keep an eye on your systems. As soon as this happened and my wind turbine melted down, the first thing I did was I called my brother, his family, because they live off grid. They live right down the road from me. And then I also called my father and my parent, my mother, because they have the same type of system I have, basically 12 volt wind turbines and all that stuff. And I called them to let them know, hey, you guys should really watch your system to see if anything's going funky on you guys, because we had those high winds. And I in this video that you guys were seeing that's all put together, I show you guys the amps that's coming off my father's wind turbine. and how fast that thing was spinning too. So today was a pretty intense day as far as wind. I mean, it's still windy right now, but man, just ruling my whole day because we're supposed to be framing the house and getting everything going for the house, the new off-grid house, and it was too windy, too unsafe to be outside. And then, you know, I was having fun watching my wind turbines power away and do its thing, and then finally it crapped out. You know, and the whole thing is I could have turned off the wind turbine a long time ago, but I didn't want to do that because I actually wanted to see it break. I wanted to see what components was going to fail at what amps. You know what I mean? Because then that gives you a good test, and that's a lot of good information to tell people that may be watching my videos. You know, like, you know, at 50 amps, you know, this is what's going to happen to your system, or at 80 amps or whatever it may be. But considering my amp meter only goes up to 50, and it went past 50, it pegged out and just kept going. There's no way of telling it what amps my system failed. One of my buddies on here on YouTube, he subscribes to me, he comments a lot. He keeps telling me I need a bigger amp meter. I need a 100 amp meter. And well, it might be time to upgrade that amp meter. So that way I could actually see how far it got up there. All right, guys. Watch your system. Always watch it. Don't just set it and forget it. You know, you always want to kind of monitor it, check on things, make sure everything's good. Because worst case scenario is if I wasn't home today and we had these strong winds and that fuse didn't pop and the windmill was still going and that didn't blow up or melt down, all this stuff in here was going to turn into slag, melt, and start falling apart. And then this could have caused a fire, you know? So that's dangerous because, you know, if you got a fire going, I mean, you're going to burn your whole system up. You're going to burn your house down. You know, you're going to catch a lot of things on fire, and you just don't need that when you're dealing with things. That's a big hit to your pocket and financially and emotionally, because you lose everything if your house catches on fire. So I may want to bring my fuse down, but I really don't want that because I want it to be around the 50 amp range. But now seeing this, I may have to put maybe a 45 amp fuse and limit myself to 45 amps for the big wind turbine. But we'll play around with it and we'll see what happens. If it's just a matter of the wires in the back of the wind turbine touching and grounding out or shorting out in any way, then I'll just fix that. And then I'll just make sure I don't buy this model anymore. I'll just make sure I buy the real big solid model. It's a little bit more expensive, but it's going to be well worth it because this could have been a big issue. So, all right, guys, see you guys in the next video. I got a lot of stuff coming up. Stay tuned, subscribe, and like, and share. All right, guys.